Hi, I'm Teresa Woodard with the Museum of Riverside, and we're here with Gabriella, another edition of Inside the Vault.
Yes, thanks for joining us. Fun to chat as always. I'm looking forward to diving into this, but I have to be honest, I don't quite know exactly what it is.
Well, as you can see here, a child would go right there. So this is a type of stroller. Okay. It's called a pole stroller. We're usually used to strollers that you would push along either from the back or the front. Old prams were typically like that. This is a different style that was popularized around the 1880s, 1890s, and would be available probably into the 1920s even.
Interesting. Okay, so some of our grandparents could have possibly
owned
one.
Have.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, the reason we have it highlighted today is because it is a part of an important family here in Riverside, the Harada family.
Right.
We've mentioned them before, so I'm excited to learn a little bit more about how this was theirs.
Yeah, so we've talked about this a little bit in some of our other videos, but the Harada House is a historic house that is a part of the Museum of Riverside. So we are the stewards of that house, and with that came the entire contents of that house. So this stroller was a part of that collection that came to the museum after we were donated the house. We don't have any pictures of any of the children in this particular stroller, but we do know that the kids in that family were really a big part of the history of the Haradas.
Now, speaking of the specific stroller, what do you feel that this represents in terms of the Harada family?
Oh, like I said, it's the children, and the children are really the focus of that story of the Haradas. Not only as they acquired their home during the turn of the last century, the 19th century, around 1910, 1915, they were searching for a home for their family. They lost one of their sons to diphtheria, and they really thought that that was brought on by their living conditions. They lived in a rooming house, a boarding house, and it was very crowded, not a lot of places for the kids to go outside and get fresh air. So they blamed that illness on their living conditions and really wanted to provide a better life for their kids.
Yeah, sad story that kind of turns good.
So. Yeah, so they start looking for a house, and they find one here in Riverside on Lemon Street, and they purchase that. And because at the time, Japanese Americans could not own property. Immigrants from Japan could not own property. There were a lot of racist and nativist laws at the time that kept people from owning land. So they put the deed of the house in their children's name, that made it so that they could purchase the property.
Yeah, I love that story. It's fun hearing. So I feel like for me, at least, it's a lot easier to envision how you guys preserve kind of smaller items.
Mm-hmm.
You kind of look around when you're in here. Obviously, you guys can't see because we're inside the vault. But a larger item like this, how do you preserve that?
Yeah, so this is a good example of something that has many materials on it. So it's not just one material. You see a lot of the metalwork here. That would have to be treated one way.
Okay.
There's also this, the rubberized wheels that you can see in some of these places that has started to degrade. Mm-hmm. And then there's also wood. So there's several different materials on this. This would be something, if it were to be conserved, it has not been conserved, but if it were to be conserved, it would require many steps in that conservation due to the different materials.
So I think a fun mention would be that not only is the museum preserving items from the house, you're also preserving the house itself.
That's right. So the house has been in the museum's possession for quite some time, but we recently received quite a large grant from the state of California.
That's great.
And we are using that to not only preserve the house, but also to develop an interpretive center that will be next door. So visitors can come and learn about the story of the Harada family.
What other items from the Harada house will be featured in the museum?
So once we open that interpretive center, we will have a place to highlight the collections that we have here at the museum from the Haradas. I mentioned when the house was donated, we received an entire house of artifacts. So all of those currently are inside the vault, and we'd love to share those with the community. We have a full archive of Everything from photographs of the family to old telephone bills. So we really have just about everything that they used in their day-to-day lives in that house. So as we go through, we find things such as the stroller, such as amazing photos of the family, both in studios, in their backyard, just really sweet family moments that really also illustrate this how important children and family were to the Harradas. They had 6 children and ended up adopting another. So at the end of the day, they were raising 7 children in that house.
Yeah, such a good reminder for all of us and such an important part of Riverside as well.
Absolutely.
Well, thank you, Teresa, for your time, for lending all of your wealth of information. And it was fun learning about the Harrada house and some of their items and what we have to look forward to.
Yeah, it was fun to be here with you also.
Thank you. And thanks for watching another episode of Inside the Vault.